Welcome back to my channel. As you can read from the title, today's video is going to be a review on the Maybelline Matte Poreless Foundation, and this is in the color Coconut 355. Now, as you guys know, I've been to Aruba, and before I even went, I already knew that I was gonna be on the hunt for this foundation because, number one, it's affordable, and two, it's matte. As you guys know, I have oily skin. My T-zone, especially my nose, is very oily, so I definitely have to dry out matte foundations more. And this is definitely the first one that I wanted to try, so I was on the hunt for it. And before, I didn't know that Maybelline came out with a new line of shades, like different, like darker shades and whatnot. And I just thought that the 355 was the darkest shade, but turns out that it's not. So too bad. But this is the darkest shade that I could find, so that's what I went for. I'm really excited to try this out. Like everyone was like, you know, Dami just need to chill and it just calm down. But guys, like I'm so excited because I'm really hoping that this shade looks good on me and that I finally found like a good matte foundation to rock. So yeah, let's get started. So I already moisturized my skin and I already did my eyebrows, as you can see. So I'm gonna jump straight in and open up the foundation. Now I already know that this foundation doesn't have a bump, which I really wish it had a bump. It would be much easier. But yeah, I'm just gonna pour it on top of my Amuse palette. I'm just gonna apply some random dots on my face. It smells, I don't know why, but this kind of smells like alcohol. I should check the ingredients. It probably has like some in it, I don't know. All the foundation that I poured on, because I don't like wasting stuff. I know this looks really awkward, but yeah. I put it down before I break it, because yeah, it's made of glass, which is another thing that I don't really like because it can easily break with my clumsiness. I'm just going to use my round sponge. Excuse the foundation that's already on it. Okay. That is not. Or maybe I just pour on a bit too much. Okay. Your mama, and I want I look like a ghost right now. I'm not gonna. I look like my background right now. You know, I'm just. Maybe I put on a bit too much. I'm just gonna wipe some of it off and then blend it again.
Take your body to places. Girl, I wanna be yours. Future entertainment.
So guys, I took quite a bit off and I blended it again with my sponge, and now it doesn't look as bad as in the beginning, but you can just see that this is not my color. It's too light. Yeah. And I also took away my artificial lighting, and yeah, this is what it looks like with just natural lighting. And this is what it looks like with my phone. I mean, it's not as bad as in the beginning. And my face is much lighter than the rest of my body, but still, it's a bit weird. I'm gonna do the rest of my makeup and then I'm gonna check what it's gonna look like when I'm done. Yeah. So guys, I just got done doing the rest of my makeup and this is what it's looking like. So sure anymore if I put too much of it in the beginning, or if the foundation adjusted to my skin, because now it's not that bad. Let me show you guys what it looks like with some artificial lighting. Maybe I just put too much in the beginning, because now it doesn't look that bad. Can you see the glow? So yeah, my final thoughts on this foundation are definitely too much of it, because that's probably what I did wrong in the beginning, because I was looking orange. You guys saw I was looking really orange, and now it's like it oxidizes and it kind of adjusted to my skin and it looks a bit better now. I know it's not the perfect shade for me, I know. But it looks a bit better now. It seems to be matte. It's definitely a matte foundation. I can just feel it. It's not a full coverage foundation, that's for sure. But it is a medium coverage foundation, because around my mouth is a bit darker, and you can still see a little bit of that peeking through. But it does give me more coverage than my clean color foundation that I always use. And I also used a new product that from Clean Color as well. I also use that to highlight under my eyes, my chin, and my forehead. And I did a little bit of reverse contouring with this foundation as well. This is the Clean Color Skin Deep Lightweight Stick Foundation, and it has SPF 50 in it. This is what it looks like, and this is in the color Nutmeg. So this is exactly my skin color, and since the Maybelline is a bit lighter than my skin color, I choose to go for a darker foundation to like highlight and do the reverse contouring and stuff. So I didn't like use my normal lipstick that I always use to contour. You guys know I use lipstick to contour. And then I also used my Amuse contour powder to set my face. You guys also know that I don't use it as contour because it's way too light. It's like exactly my skin tone, so I just set my face with that. And as my mascara, I used another new product. I have tried it out already, but you guys, this is my first time telling you guys about it. And I used the Golden Rose Miracle Lash Ultra Black Mascara. And like, guys, let me show you. Can you guys see? Wow, like I'm in love with this mascara, and this is what I've been using lately. I really love it. It really like burns out my lashes. And yeah, I just went for a red lip with a little bit of black lip liner. I am going to use this foundation now because it's matte and I am oily, so I am going to keep on using it. And yeah, that is it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope it was informative for you guys. And yeah, thanks for this is so awkward me holding the phone like this, but yeah, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video, which I will be recording after this one. So yeah, thanks for watching, and bye.